Hello everyone, Eddie the Magic Monk here. Welcome to our final SQL tutorial for today. I'm probably not going to do another one for a while, so this is probably enough for you guys to understand most of SQL after watching this tutorial. So as you can see, I have three tables in this database. Okay, I've got a list of subjects in a school, a list of students in the school, and a list of which students are enrolled in which subject. So what we're going to teach you today is how to join these three tables together into one big table. So if I create another query, so let's open up select query 9, let's edit this query. And what we're going to do is we're going to select star from enrollment. And that is obviously going to create just a copy of the enrollment table, which has subject ID and student ID. So let's just do that. Let's do select subject ID, student ID. Now, just in preparation for the join, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give the enrollment table an alias, or in other words, a nickname. So enrollment E. So the nickname for enrollment is now E. So whenever I want to refer to a field in that table, I can just put E dot subject ID, E dot student ID. That means that these two fields belong to the enrollment table. Right now it's sort of pointless to do that, but you can see why we do it soon. Now if we want to join two tables together, for example, I'm going to now join the enrollment table and the subject table. So enrollment E, and I'm going to put in here subjects S. S represents a variable for the subjects table. So I'm going to select E dot subject ID and S dot subject name. Now here's where it's important. You have to say how you want them to join. You have to put where E dot subject ID is equal to S dot subject ID, because if you don't put this there, it's not going to understand how you want to join them. So now let's run this. So design run, and you can see next to each subject I got subject ID 1 English, subject ID 1 English, and subject 2 maths, and so on. So let's now join up the students with the enrollment table as well. So let's go back to SQL. Let's put students. Well, I can't put S because then I'll have two tables with the same nickname. So I'm going to put students as U. Okay, so because I have three tables, I now have to say how I want them to join. So where enrollment dot student ID is equal to U dot, so inside the students table I got S underscore ID. So that's how those two tables will be linked. So I got the enrollment table, which has student ID, and this is the same as in the students table, we got the students ID. So for example, next to student ID number 1, I'm gonna have the name Smith. So I'm gonna put in here comma U dot last name. So if I run this, it's gonna give me a syntax error, which is unfortunate. Where did I go wrong? And forgot the AND keyword. So run it. So it works. Now I have the subject name and the student name that's enrolled in that subject. So three tables linked into one. So obviously you can add more conditions to that. So if I only want to list the people in the math subject, then I can do AND S dot subject name is equal to English or maths. So if I run this, then I should only get the math subject. Right? Only got the math subject and the people enrolled in the math subject. Okay, I hope this tutorial helps you guys join tables together. Thanks for watching. See you next time.